2022 marked the beginning of a new era of Texas State soccer with the introduction of head coach Steve Holeman. A team that exceeded expectations, nearly doubled its win total from the year before. This season, they look to take another step towards the ultimate goal of winning a Sun Belt Conference title. And with that, we welcome you to this special season preview of Bobcat Soccer in 2023, along with head coach Steve Holeman. I'm Brant Freeman. A marquee year for the program, season number 25 of Bobcat Soccer, year two for Coach Holeman. Looking back at year one, Coach, how fun was that?
Great season. Always nice to take over a program and get to meet some new players. Just fantastic start to my tenure here.
So you look back at the offseason since the end of last year. What's been the biggest emphasis for you and your staff in preparation for this coming year?
Yeah, we just wanted to use our offseason to get ready for this fall. Had a couple transfers in, so they did pretty well, and we had some really competitive games through the spring, so we felt like that helped us get ready.
Yeah, no, something I learned about you over the offseason, you're quite the trivia buff, aren't you?
I like trivia. I enjoy it. I don't know if I'm a buff, but yeah.
Trivia nights in St. Marcus can be pretty fun, but some trivia about your team from a year ago. Let's take a look at what you accomplished in 2022. You look at the win-loss record, 12 wins last season, a 5-win improvement from the year before, 6-3-1 in Sun Belt play, good for third in a very good West Division. And you look there at the home wins, 8 for you this past season, tied for the second most in program history. How great were the environments at Bobcat Soccer Stadium this past year?
Absolutely phenomenal. It's always great to be at home. Any coach will tell you that. We have Boca's Army that shoots off smoke when we score goals, and just they really get the crowd going. Great to be in front of family, friends, and students.
Yep. You know what really gets those crowds riled up, of course, is scoring the goals themselves, right? You see the goal smoke going off from Boca's Army. And we saw the numbers there, and your offense was very productive a season ago. And one of the biggest things was the ability to get those corner kicks. Take us back through what your offense was able to accomplish a season ago.
Well, we felt it was going to be pretty important to be really good on set pieces. Mm-hmm. It always is. And so we spent a lot of extra time working on both attacking and defensive set pieces, and we were pretty productive in that area. So obviously converted quite a few on corners. So sometimes, and many times, that's the difference in a game.
I mentioned this is season number 25 for the program. For you, you're getting ready for your 29th year as the head coach of a soccer program. Of course, previously at Lamar, time in the SEC, Georgia, and Ole Miss. You're approaching the 300-win milestone. You're 4 shy entering this season. Is it kind of surreal for you to hear all that, to realize it's almost 3 decades now and almost 300 wins?
Well, when you put it that way, 3 decades certainly sounds like a lot. I try not to keep track of that. 29 years is a long time. Mm-hmm. Thanks for the reminder.
No problem. Just trying to age you here a little bit. I mentioned the win total. You added to that with a dozen last year. Of those 12 wins, 10 of them came by a single goal. What did it say about your team and its ability to win those tight matches?
Mental toughness, always fighting throughout games, competing through every minute, and several games came down to the very last minute, as you know. So it was great to be on, the winning end of those.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's kind of a recap of 2022. Coach Holeman and I will talk more about the coming season, 2023, later in our preview. But up next, we talk to one of the vets on his team, team captain Bailey Peschel. That's coming up as our season preview continues right after this.
stay on my way. I want it, I take it, I'm on it, I'm jaded, I'm on it, amazing. I'm scoring so many people count, yeah, just don't count me out, yeah.
Ready for the Bobcats' next home game by getting your tickets online at txtbobcats.com today.
People are always searching for what's next. At Texas State University, we are driving what's next. And next is now.
Nothing beats experience, and the student athlete joining us now has that in droves. More than 2,500 career minutes on the field and entering her fifth year with the program. That is Bailey Peschel joining us now as our season preview continues of Bobcat soccer in this upcoming 2023 year. And Bailey, thank you for being here. And I mentioned this is year five for you. A season ago, though, you got halfway through the end of non-conference play in the preparation for the beginning of Sun Belt play. Suffered a knee injury that ended your season. How tough was that, and what have you been doing to get ready for this year?
To say I was heartbroken would be an understatement. I still remember the feeling when they told me that my ACL might be torn, mm-hmm. and waking up the next day was worse because it was almost like a bad dream, but then knowing that that was reality. Mm-hmm. But I also think that in life there's adversity. You have two options. You can either bounce back or you can give up. And there wasn't a doubt in my mind. I knew I wasn't done playing soccer. I wanted to make a comeback. Mm-hmm. And so as crazy as it might sound, I wouldn't change anything that happened. I think it's given me a new fire. I'm mm-hmm. more determined than ever. And I just do it for the girl who had to relearn how to walk, relearn how to run. And so I'm more excited than ever to get back to season.
You were a team captain a year ago. You are again going into this year. And I remember when the injury happened, watching home matches during conference play and seeing you out there, you know, on crutches, supporting your teammates. For you, why was it important as your role as captain to still be there with your team as they were continuing their season?
To me, leadership is all about lifting other people up. And mm-hmm. so I just wanted to be the best teammate I could for them, whether it meant being a cheerleader on the sidelines or just checking in on people. And in the same tone, they were there for me when I needed it most. So I was just happy to be a part of the team still.
So again, you're back this season. You elected to return for a fifth year. What do you want to get out of your fifth and final season playing at Texas State?
I want to win a ring. I want to win a regular season conference and conference tournament and mm-hmm. go to the NCAA tournament and just enjoy every moment. I think we have the potential, and I'm excited to see where the season takes us.
You know, I was dating your head coach earlier by, you know, giving away how many years he's coached now. I'm kind of doing a little bit with you, the elder statesman on this team, to give you an idea just how long Bailey's been with the program. Her career began pre-COVID. It was that long ago, which really feels like 10 years ago in reality back in 2019. But with that, you did experience a coaching change. You had a chance to play for Steve Holeman for the first time last year. What have you gotten to know about your head coach?
I just think the energy that Coach Holeman brings is so special. Mm-hmm. His love of the game and just positivity is contagious. I remember in our preseason talk, he gave us a speech about just lifting each other up as teammates, and everybody left the room with chills. And mm-hmm. so I think that speaks volumes to the type of coach he is, and I'm excited to see where he takes the program.
I've heard the phrase from him, climb the hill. What does that mean?
Yes, so that means taking it day by day. There's going to be adversities throughout our season. It's not a straight path, but just really making the most out of every opportunity and continuously going upward and improving each and every chance we get.
Okay, we also talked with Coach Holeman about at times he can be a bit of a trivia buff. So I got some Bailey Peschel trivia now here as a part of this preview. Looking at some of your career highlights, the first two things that stand out to me there: last year, the team's Pride Award winner and Perseverance Award winner. What did it mean for you to be recognized by your teammates, by your coaches with those honors, despite the fact that you only played 8 matches last year?
To me, it just meant a lot that my team was there for me. I think that it was one of the hardest times of my life, for sure. Just kind of reminded me that there's a light at the end of the tunnel. Mm-hmm. And yeah, just meant a lot to be recognized by them.
You've also been recognized for your academic accomplishments, 3-time member of the Sun Belt Conference Commissioners List, three-time member of the Texas State Star Excellence list as well, maintaining a GPA 4.0 or higher for each of your first 3 years as a student-athlete at Texas State. So what is it that you're looking to accomplish in your career goals once you're done playing soccer?
So I'm currently finishing my master's in accounting degree. Mm-hmm. After graduation, I plan to study and take the CPA exam and then start working as an accountant.
Well, again, Bailey, thank you so much for joining us. The team is now counting on you to be a part of the team. Hopefully everything is behind you as far as injuries concerned, and looking forward to this coming year with you.
Thank you so much.
All right, that again, Bailey Peschel joining us. Coach Holeman is going to rejoin us here, take Bailey's seat as we look ahead to the upcoming 2023 season. We're back with more of our season preview right after this.
Texas State University, we are driving what's next. And next is now.
And we're back for our season preview. Joining us once again is head coach Steve Holeman. We just got done visiting with Bailey Peschel, a player you inherited when you took over the program a season ago. This will be your fifth year again with Texas State Soccer. Team captain for you last year, again this season. How valuable is it to have someone like Bailey in your program?
Bailey's just a phenomenal person, first and foremost, a phenomenal player, incredible work ethic, and a tremendous leader. So it, for me, was a no-brainer that she was captain. She's going to be captain this year. We're super excited that she came back for her grad year. Mm-hmm. And as you know, she's coming off a pretty rough injury, but I know that she has worked incredibly hard to be back, and we're glad to have her.
So you look at the makeup of this year's team in terms of who was back, who you lost. 17 returning letter winners from a year ago, 10 of them lost, including 5 starters from last year's team. In terms of retention, who you have back, who you lost, what do you make of your team coming into this year?
Well, the dynamics are certainly different. We lost our entire starting back line, and we have newcomers. So we've been kind of experimenting throughout preseason. We had 2 tough preseason exhibition matches, which really kind of told us and gave us a lot of information on the areas we need to work on. But we're plugging in new players into positions. I think we'll be pretty deep in each position. And so looking forward to the season getting underway.
You look at the amount of newcomers that you have, and a baker's dozen, 13 newcomers on the roster this year. And of those, 10 true freshmen. One of those, the name sounds very familiar. Anna Mae Holeman, your daughter, as part of the program now. What is the dynamic for you in being able to coach your daughter in your own program?
Well, it certainly is a special opportunity. Not every coach gets that chance to work with their own child. So Really looking forward to it. Unfortunately, she's been injured through preseason, so mm-hmm. haven't had the chance to work with her yet, but she's on her way back and just can't wait.
You know, earlier I talked about, you know, goal scoring for you and how you were able to score last season. You look now at the top returning offensive players from last year, the three that really stood out, Matty Goss, 9 goals for you a season ago, the first sophomore to lead the team in goal scoring since 2013, Zoe Jr., Olivia Wright, all three back in the fold this season. What do they bring to the table?
Well, they bring experience. They know what it takes to score goals. They know what it takes to come up big in big moments. And we're going to need that on this year's team, of course, with a lot of newcomers. Mm-hmm. So I think they all lead by example, and it'll be an important part of our success this year.
You know, of the newcomers, anybody in that group that could factor in your offense more than beyond those three?
I think offensively, we have a transfer, Maggie Somer, NAIA player, and once she makes that adjustment, she was an All-American at the NAIA level. This level's a bit higher, so mm-hmm. she's quickly adjusting, and I think she can do some damage up top. We have Victoria from El Salvador that's played with the full national team, so she's got that international experience that'll help her. She's really good with her final pass, and mm-hmm. she's a midfielder that'll make our attack much more dangerous.
Every sport has that key position, right? You talk about American football and quarterback, you know, baseball, your starting pitcher, your closer, you know, basketball, point guard, volleyball, your setter. When it comes to soccer, you're looking at the goalkeeper. You have two back from a year ago, Beth Agee, Caitlin Chrisman. You added two over the offseason. Looking at this group of four keepers, what right. stands out?
What stands out is the competitive nature of that group. The two returning, Caitlin mm-hmm. and Beth, have come back better than they were before. The two newcomers are very talented as well. So we have really a four-keeper battle, and it's going to be difficult. And that's a good news for us. Mm-hmm. You know, unfortunately, in that position, you can only start one. So, but we feel comfortable that we have really good depth in that position.
An 18-match schedule this year. You get 8 non-conference matches to start the year. The first three, all at home, McNeese, Central Arkansas, North Texas. You look further down the list, some other matches stand out. Renewing the rivalry with UTSA and a Power 5 match at home against Oklahoma State. How does this slate of 8 matches get you ready for Sun Belt play?
Well, that's always our goal in our non-conferences, to mm-hmm. get us ready for Sun Belt. And I think we face a variety of opponents, some that are a little more direct, some that are more physical, some that are good in possession, and some highly talented teams like Oklahoma State. So without question, by the time we're finished with our non-conference, we'll be ready for the Sun Belt.
I alluded to some of your coaching stops earlier, you know, Lamar, Georgia, Ole Miss, you're kind of looking there, Southland, SEC. Last year was your introduction to the Sun Belt as we now look at your 10 conference games this season. What did you take away from your first year in the conference last season?
The conference is very challenging, extremely difficult, and especially with Texas State being the outlier, when we travel, most of the time it's a flight, and mm-hmm. it's not easy being on the road, traveling all day on a Saturday and then maybe playing on a Sunday afternoon. So, and then last year we were on the road, I think 6 weekends in a row. So mm-hmm. it was extremely difficult, but it's good. It's what we want. It's why we're in this profession. We want challenges. And mm-hmm. so I think we have a team of leaders that will be prepared for that again this fall.
Well, Coach, looking forward to year 2 of the program, year 29 for you overall, and best of luck.
Thank you.
You got it. Again, that's head coach Steve Holeman. That's going to wrap up our season preview special. Be sure to tune into ESPN Plus throughout the year for more coverage of Bobcat Soccer. We'll have all the home games, with the exception of one, on the broadcast schedule, so be on the lookout for that. For Coach Holeman and Bailey Peschel, I'm Brant Freeman. Enjoy the coming season, and remember to eat them up.